The brilliant yet chronically overlooked Dr. Edwin Lupin culminates his research into the nature of time itself. Helped by his dedicated assistant Eales and Kelvin, Lupin constructs the world's first functioning time machine, which for complicated science reasons looks exactly like a portable shower. When the Science Journal publishes its list of the year's greatest inventions, the time machine is curiously absent. Oh wait, there it is. Winner of the Lamest Invention Award. Ridiculed for its appearance, the judges have dubbed it the infamous machine. Dr. Lupin, of course, accepts this setback with grace and dignity. For about 2 seconds, driven to madness, he launches himself into the past, bent on stealing credit for humanity's greatest works. Can the bumbling Kelvin, driven by a basic understanding of right and wrong, repair the unraveling timeline? Or will he totally blow it and doom the universe to oblivion?
Well, great. We're 10 seconds in, and the game already has an 18-plus rating.
Kelvin? Kelvin, can you hear me?
Ah! Eales?
Kelvin, you're alive. Are you all right?
Well, the water pressure was a little low for my taste, but...
Kelvin, focus. Where are you? What do you see?
Looks like downtown somewhere. France, maybe?
Okay, good. The system says you're actually in Austria.
Austria? Oi, good time, mate!
Austria, Kelvin. Not Australia. And it's 1804.
So, why did Lupin come here?
Likely he was after Beethoven.
The dog!
The composer, Kelvin. According to history, Ludwig von Beethoven penned just 4 symphonies before retiring in 1804. It's statistically improbable that a man of his genius would end his career so suddenly.
You're saying Lupin messed with Beethoven so he could write the rest of the symphonies himself?
Exactly. You need to find Beethoven and get him to write his 5th symphony.
Got it. So, what does the symphony sound like?
Who knows? It's been erased from history. Kelvin, the connection's breaking up. Good luck! Don't do anything stupid!
Whoa, are you a fortune teller?
You got it. Fortunes, divinations, and prophetic prognostications. Only thing I don't do is palm reading. Oh, refunds.
Could you tell my fortune? Huh?
Oh, wish I could. But a dark and terrible evil has rendered me powerless.
A ghost is draining you of your spiritual aura?
Nah, some jerk tourist ran off with my crystal ball.
Didn't see that coming, did you?
What can I say? Divination is a mysterious and fecal craft.
Come on, can't you do a really basic fortune without your crystal ball?
I don't know. Can you build a really basic castle without any rocks?
Point taken. Have you seen visions of what the world will be like in 200 years?
Sure have. Crazy place. Mechanical carriages speed around without needing horses to pull them. There's all sorts of delicious sugary foods, but people keep eating kid for some reason. Oh, and everybody has a magic rectangle that they use to send each other pictures of their privates.
Wow, you're good. Any idea where I could find Beethoven?
Is that a street?
I'm gonna take that as a no. See you later.
I know.
test your might.
Will this work for a crystal ball replacement?
Hey, thanks. This should work great. Let me repay the favor with a complimentary fortune.
Complimentary as in free, right?
That's the one.
Awesome!
The shapes are indistinct. Your fate seems yet undecided. Wait, never mind. Somebody's definitely going to shoot you.
What? Are you serious?
Yep, it's right there in the ball.
Whatever happened to divination is a mysterious and fickle craft?
This time it was mysteriously clear.
Oh, man. Well, thanks, I guess.
Tell your friends.
You there, little boy.
Are you talking to me?
Well, sonny.
Dude, I'm 26.
Well, don't you have quite the imagination?
Are you serious? I'm... Wait a minute. Is this the ring toss?
Indeed it is.
Oh, boy! Can I play, mister? Please?
Oh, of course, sonny. If you've got a few coins to spare, that is.
Oh, man, it's always something. Could I play just once without paying? Where I'm from, they let you play a little for free, and then suddenly you can't stop.
I'm afraid not, lad. Portly carnival workers need to eat, too. You understand.
What do I get if I win?
Tonight's prize is a ticket to the acclaimed Vienna Symphony.
Whoa! Fancy.
You bet your bottom.
What's with the creepy vase over there?
Oh, that? It belongs to the snake charmer.
Is he on break?
I'm afraid he's in the hospital. He had a touch too much of the drink and tried charming the flute by playing the cobra.
Whoops. Bye, ring toss dude.
Come back anytime.
Slow night, huh?
Right now, all the rich snobs are next door listening to their rich snob music.
That's who drinks here? Rich snobs?
Everybody in there is either a rich snob or knows a rich snob. Them's the rules.
Any crazy-eyed scientists come through here lately?
You kidding? This is Vienna. Half the people here are crazy-eyed weirdos.
How about like a really small crazy-eyed weirdo?
Sorry, kid. Pretty much everybody looks small to me. Now move along.
Can I go inside?
No.
Why not?
This joint has a strict dress code.
It does, but you're wearing a ratty old tank top.
Do I look like I'm inside?
Touché, bouncer. So I can go in if I find fancier clothes?
Nope.
Well, what else is the matter?
You don't look old enough to drink.
That's just because I moisturize.
Likely story. What year were you born?
2000 and,
Nice try, kid. Go play at the carnival or something.
I know the owner, pal. If you don't let me in right now, I'll get him to fire you.
Yeah? What's his name?
His name? It's, Glenn. Glenn Hunt.
Sorry, buddy. Glenn Hunt sold this joint about a month ago. New ownership.
Oh, come on. Do you know if Beethoven is in there?
Who?
Ludwig van Beethoven, the legendary composer.
What's he look like?
Crazy hairdo, death glare, kind of hard of hearing.
Oh, the deaf guy. Yeah, he's in there. Looked real annoyed about something when he came in.
I'll be back.
I'll be here.
You expect me to pay just to park here?
Think of it as a status symbol. Parking here says, I have so much money I wasted on parking for no reason.
That is brilliant! Hey, Franz! I see you've parked for free! Like a peasant!
Is there a concert going on in there?
There is.
Can I go in?
You cannot. Tickets are sold out.
How do you know I don't have a ticket?
Call it a hunch. Ticketed patrons only.
Wow, they really captured his creepy over-caffeinated essence.
Have some respect. Lupin is the greatest genius in history.
Whatever. I once saw him try to eat a burrito like it was corn on the cob. Whoa, a Stradivarius! That's like the Stradivarius of violins! One ring toss, please. Here's your money.
Thank you, lad. Here's your ring. Step right up, hook a target, and win!
Ring toss. Sounds fun.
More fun than a warehouse full of barley, my boy. Come on up and try your luck. Well, don't just stand there, sonny. Give it a go.
My desire to create art has been trumped by my desire to pick up this comically oversized ring.
How the devil did you? You cheated me!
You've been out-cheated, you cheaty cheater! Now where's my prize?
Fine. Here.
That's probably safe. Read it and weep, cucumber face. One symphony ticket.
What the? Where did you find this?
It doesn't matter and you know it. Now let me through.
Oh, very well. Try not to ruin the entire performance with your blabbering.
No promises. Why would somebody make a ladder this short? Wait a minute! Gnomes must be real! Is this mop made of human hair? Well, sure is. Oh, yuck. No, I'd rather not.
What are you doing over there?
Me? Just admiring some fine musical craftsmanship.
I've got my eye on you.
This cobra knows good music when he hears it. I am not a smart man.
Kelvin, are you there? What's your status?
My status? Good.
Great. What progress have you made?
Well, earlier I won a rigged carnival game, and just now I put a cobra in my backpack.
No need to be a smartass, Kelvin.
I'm not. I really did those things.
Wow, that's much worse. Kelvin, please stop handling venomous things and start saving the world, okay?
I'm on it.
I don't recall you checking any garments.
Sounds like somebody's got a fuzzy memory.
Have a pleasant evening.
Behold the perfect snooty disguise! Boom! Just call me Lord Kelvin. Wait, I think that's taken.
Good evening, smelly door person. I am filthy sausage mogul Abraham von Frohman, and I demand admittance into this cosmopolitan beer hall.
Good evening, Herr Frohman. Please come right in. Wait a minute. Have I seen you here before, Herr Frohman?
What? No, nope. I am visiting from Schnitzelberg.
My mistake. Enjoy your evening, sir.
Kelvin, come in. Kelvin, why are you dressed like that fancy peanut?
I used the power of disguise to sneak into an upscale bar.
Oh, wow. I'm so glad you've prioritized drinking over the impending doom of the universe.
Two birds with one stone, Lise. I have it on semi-decent authority that Beethoven is somewhere in this bar right now.
Well, hurry up and get him back on track. The system's detected another temporal disturbance. Lupin's still at it.
You can count on Abraham von Frohman.
Who is that?
It's me. I invented a brilliant pseudonym to complete my disguise.
Ugh, whatever works, Kelvin.
Hello, friend. Take a seat and try your luck against the reigning champion.
You want me to arm wrestle that jack dude? No chance!
Au contraire, mon ami. No. Not arm wrestle. Pop shaker.
You mean rock, paper, scissors?
Yes, that one. That is the one right there in the middle.
What do I get if I win?
you get the most best prize in the world. Beer!
Oh, hell yeah! Let's do this!
You lose!
What the? Did you just shoot me? Oh, maybe this is what that fortune teller was talking about.
Ah, looks like someone's never played tournament rules before. Come back when you've studied up, kiddo.
Welcome, sir. What can I get you?
I'll take a needlessly elaborate cocktail.
Outstanding choice, sir. I'll prepare you my signature drink, the Ardolin Samimi. The September issue of Snobbery describes it as acerbic yet plummy with subtle hints of lavender and beef. You're really gonna like this.
Baller! How the heck did you get in here? You don't meet the dress code at all.
Easy. I've been in here since before they had one.
When did they start?
I don't know. 4 years ago?
You, sir, are a legend.
Cheers to that, brother.
I better be careful with these. I'm pretty allergic.
Not to mention they've been here longer than I have.
Welcome, sir. What can I get you?
Give me the strongest thing you got.
The Molaskia, sir? I'm afraid that particular drink requires a prescription.
Whoa. How come?
The last few patrons to order it experienced some ill effects.
What, like a stomachache?
They imploded.
Cool. Beer me, barkeep.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. We only have one beer left, and it's reserved for the winner of the Rock, Paper, Scissors tournament.
One beer?
Yeah, that ornery composer over there has been drinking us dry.
I'm good for now.
I am at your service, sir.
Excuse me, sir, are you Ludwig van Beethoven? Sir? Ludwig?
Sir, are you Beethoven?
Who are you? What's the places do you want? And speak up!
I am here to help you write your next symphony!
There will be no next symphony.
Why not? You're so good!
Perhaps you failed to notice, but I can barely hear a thing.
I did notice! When did that happen?
Hours ago. I was accosted by a wild-eyed shrub of a man from some infernal horn. He flooded mine ears with a terrible, screeching tone. Now, the only sound I hear clearly is that of this damned mug striking the table as I drink my misery away.
What are you working on there? A world-changing musical masterpiece?
This is no music. It's a poem to help me soothe my pained and withered soul.
Oh, can I hear what you've got so far?
I close my eyes and scream. It does not reach my ear. Music is like a dream, one that I cannot hear.
Yikes, maybe stick to instrumentals.
Say again?
I said that's really deep. How about this? I'll start a melody, and you can just run with it. Ba 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 ba. Do 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 do. La 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 ba
Stop that! Stop that right now!
Excuse me, Mr...
Kruislink. Dr. Kruislink. Can I help you?
My legs feel all mushy. I need a prescription for Malaskia before it's too late.
Likely a mild case of syphilis.
Indeed.
Indeed. I recommend 6 iodine tablets and a week's bed rest.
Dang it.
Hey, Doc, you think I could have that Malaskia prescription now?
Good heavens! An acute facial dysmography! Oh, this affliction is far beyond my ability to treat. Here, enjoy one last beverage before your head blows up. My condolences.
Thanks!
Ha! I haven't pulled that trick since my organic chemistry final. One Malaskia, please. Here's my prescription.
Very good, sir. Before I make this, however, I am required to inform you of the following disclaimers. Malaskia is not recommended for consumption by the ill or infirm. Do not drink Malaskia with other forms of alcohol. Do not drink Malaskia before or after operating a threshing machine. Do not drink Malaskia in the vicinity of a fountain or decorative clock. Do not drink Malaskia in Spain. Do not drink Malaskia during an existential crisis. Do not spell Malaskia. Do not drink Malaskia upside down. Do not think that drinking Malaskia somehow makes you better than Malaskia. If Malaskia asks you a question, do not answer. And finally, do not drink Malaskia. Do you acknowledge and accept these disclaimers, sir?
Yeah, whatever. Gimme!
What business do you have with the Shuffler?
Could I borrow your cards?
Cards? What is the Shuffler without his cards? What is a muskox without his musk? What is the barrel salesman without his mini barrels?
All right. I got it. Ooh, can I show you a magic trick?
The Shuffler does not deign to engage in petty trickery, magical or otherwise. He is the practitioner of an art. You would do well to respect it.
Looks like somebody needs a drink refill.
The Shuffler is awed by your observational prowess.
If I bring you a drink, will you let me borrow your cards for a few minutes?
The Shuffler is not one to make promises, but... perhaps.
The Kelvin will see you later.
The Shuffler does not appreciate your mockery.
Here you are, Mr. Shuffler. It's the bartender's latest creation, the, Alice. Subversively sweet, with notes of dolphin and basement mold.
The Shuffler accepts your gift with skepticism and curiosity.
I'm sure it'll be fine. Will this deck of cards work?
Yes, these should do the trick. Let's see. The answer to your quandary is lost forever at the bottom of the Dead Sea.
What? I can't even swim!
Wait, oh, sorry. Cards were upside down. The answer to your quandary is at the bottom left corner of a parchment wall.
Oh, cryptic.
You know it.
Rock? That's too mainstream for me. I was always more of a scissors guy. Real talk. Anybody who tells you they like throwing paper is lying. Heck yeah, scissors. Can't lose with scissors. Weird. Gun beats rock, paper, and scissors, but horns beat gun? Horns, huh? They lose rock, paper, and scissors, but beat gun, for some reason. Boom! Take that, silent scowling guy! You just got wrecked! Oh god, thank you for the friendly and competitive match! Please don't rip off my arms. One victory beer, please. Hey, there's a giant hole in my mug?
Yes, sir. I added that to let the beer breathe properly. It should improve mouthfeel.
Well, okay, except the beer just spilled all over the counter.
Oh, right. Liquids. Sorry, sir. I'd pour you a replacement, but we're all out.
I'm not sure how those go together. Nice. Looks like a party. What's the occasion?
Occasion? Bro, please!
You don't need an occasion to pound the brews with your bros, bro. Now come on, bro, join us in a broast.
What?
A broast, bro? A bro toast?
Sure. Let me go grab a mug.
All right, bros, let's do this.
Heck yeah, bro.
Instability just fell by 30%!
No!
Kelvin, that's a good thing.
Oh. Yay!
I kind of can't believe it, but whatever you're doing is actually working.
So you're saying I can come home now and binge-watch Star Snails?
What? No. We need to get you to the next temporal anomaly immediately.
But Star Snails...
Kelvin, you can't watch Star Snails if Lupin implodes the universe.
Yeah, fine. Beam in the shower or whatever.
Beaming in now. See you on the other side, Kelvin.
Ugh, drain hair.
Eat your heart out, McFly.
You there, Kelvin?
Present and accounted for.
All right. The system says you're in London now, and odds are good you're there to help Isaac Newton.
The science fiction dude.
You're thinking of Isaac Asimov.
The, violinist.
Itzhak Perlman.
Ah, the Swedish tennis player.
Kelvin, that's Bjorn Borg. Look. In 1672, Isaac Newton published groundbreaking research on the nature of optics. And after that...
Nothing else?
Bingo. Lupin must have meddled with Newton's later research somehow.
Gotcha. I'll get him back on track. Do we, know what else he might have been working on?
I have no clue, but I imagine he does. Good luck, Kelvin.
This book return is full of mail. I guess the postman got confused. I'll just grab a few letters. They probably weren't going to reach their destination anyway. I shall returneth thine horn forthwith, noble knight. Wow. Really wasn't expecting to get away with that one. Are you in charge here?
As much as any librarian can claim to be in charge of such magnificent tomes of truth.
Okay.
How might I assist you, fellow knowledge seeker?
What do you know about that Newton dude?
That Newton dude happens to be one of England's great mathematical minds.
Neat. What's he been working on?
He claimed to be nearing a breakthrough regarding some fundament of nature. Recently, however, he stopped working entirely to read those silly Larry Plotter novels.
Larry Plotter novels?
Some nonsense about a magical child and his embarrassing dating life. The books appeared here just last week, addressed to Professor Newton. He hasn't put them down since.
Well, that's suspicious. Got any book recommendations?
You absolutely must read The Stabbing by Denise Danil. A young noblewoman inherits a decorative letter opener from a distant relative.
But it's cursed and it forces her to stab people with it?
Wow. No, but that would be much better.
Neat magnet.
Very. It is this library's most prized non-book object. As rare as it is powerful. I spend most of my time staring directly at it.
Fun. See you around.
Onward. Toward enlightenment.
Oh, come on! Now he gets a wooden statue?
I agree. It is a bit underwhelming. A genius like Lupin deserves the finest marble. Not to mention his left hand has been loose for ages.
Excuse me, sir. I was wondering if...
No spoilers!
What?
No spoilers! I'm only on book four.
Book four of what?
The Larry Plata series, obviously. This J.K. Lupin fellow spins quite the yarn. Now, what do you want?
Are you Isaac Newton?
Yes.
I've come here to help you.
Help me with what?
You know, the thing you need help with. Science, maybe?
If you authentically wish to help me, you can start by leaving me alone.
How many of those Larry Plotter books do you have left to read?
46.
Are you serious? That'll take forever.
I am perfectly aware that I'm behind. No need to rub it in.
You don't understand. I'm from the future. Whatever you were working on before you started reading these books is critical to the fate of the entire universe.
Dear God. You're quoting a part I haven't gotten to yet, aren't you?
No, I'm telling you...
La 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 la, stop ruining stuff! La 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 la!
Can I feel your wig?
What? Absolutely not.
Please? It looks like a big poofy sheep.
If I say yes, will you swear never to disturb me again?
Yes! Wait, no. Kind of?
Oh, forget I asked.
I'll let you get back to it.
How exceedingly generous.
Did you just take some of my wood chips?
I'll bring them back?
You better. I'm making a salad later.
Ugh, gross. Aha! It looks like there's one coal down there that isn't super hot. What, the carbonated tea?
Yes, sir. Best in the city. Or at least it will be as soon as I'm done perfecting the recipe. Care for a cup?
What's in it?
Trade secret, my friend.
It's not people, right? I saw this one movie where it was people...
Trade secret, my friend.
What's that crazy machine behind you?
It's called a gronk.
What the heck does that stand for?
Not a clue. It's from Prussia. Makes marvelous tea, though.
So, how does the gronk work?
I couldn't rightly tell you. The manual's in German. It's a bit finicky about what you put in it, though. I left a few twigs in the last batch and nearly blew the whole thing to pieces.
What? Are you sure that thing's even meant for making tea?
No, sir.
I should go.
Come back anytime.
This funnel is the greatest funnel I have ever seen. I must have it.
You can't have it.
But I must have it.
But you can't have it. Come on then, try a cuppa. It's on the house while I'm still working on the mixture.
All right, sure. Hit me.
That's the spirit.
Oh, dear God! It itches and burns! Oh, it's like a liquid rash.
Just the kick you need to start your day!
I have to make sure nobody else makes the same mistake I did.
Fancy another cup? I've tweaked the settings to make it even more delicious.
All right, sure. Hit me.
That's the spirit. Fie, not again.
Yoink!
Oh, confound it all!
This stuff is rank! It's gotta be useful for something, though.
Oh, joy. You again.
Looks like you have some mail.
Oh, perhaps my Larry Plotter fan club application has been approved.
Thanks for the help, conveniently placed bushes.
Kelvin, what did you do?
Well, I certainly didn't just talk to some bushes.
Kelvin, Isaac Newton is currently known throughout history.
Perfect. Mission accomplished.
For having written the single worst fan fiction ever.
Oh, okay. But how do we know that isn't what he's supposed to be famous for?
The fan fiction is titled Larry Plotter and the Insufferable Nuisance in the Ugly Vest.
Well, I mean, that could be anybody.
Damn it, Kelvin! The temporal lattice is starting to unravel! I'll do what I can to stabilize it from here, but you need to fix whatever you did, and fast! Lee's out!
The rust came right off. Amazing. Oh god, I sound like an infomercial. Uh-oh. Looks like this ball return has a faulty, transistor.
A faulty what?
Transistor. It's highly technical. Fortunately, I have a replacement right here. Go ahead, take a test shot. Good as new. Okay, bye. Thank you.
Oh, look out! It's a self-righteous conservationist!
Where? Don't do that to me, man! My blood pressure can't handle it.
Looks like this fence is short one peg. Under reparation. It's locked up tight.
Pulverized!
Take that, sulfur! Serves you right for smelling like butt. Whoa, I think I just reinvented gunpowder! Door ready for breach!
Say your prayers, door!
Kelvin, I managed to buy us a little more time, but... Kelvin, you have the look in your eye that you get whenever you explode something. Did you explode something?
Me? No!
Kelvin!
Okay, maybe, but it's critical to the mission! This door was, like, super locked.
Did you try knocking?
Knocking is for chumps, Lees. You've always said that.
I have literally never said... Uh-oh. Kelvin, I just picked up another disturbance. This one's real bad. Get Newton sorted now! Then? Whatever.
Thwack! You know what? I'm always just picking up objects and shoving them into my backpack. This time, I'm doing it with style.
Ads. Guess I'll stick to the basics.
Please do not touch the magnet, unless you have a scholarly reason to do so.
Actually, I'm here to inspect the magnet for, magnetic distortions. Extremely dangerous.
Oh, dear. Please, feel free to take a look. I do ask, however, that we keep the magnet inside the library.
See you around.
Onward, toward enlightenment.
Whoa! This this disc is seriously magnetized. Nice statues.
What the... How did you get up here?
I used the door, silly.
The door was supposed to be locked.
Please leave!
My art requires the utmost precision.
No, really, look! The statue is super crooked.
Mon Dieu, I can't believe it! But you're right! I must correct this immediately.
Yelled Larry Plotter. He was pulled toward the ground with a force proportional to...
Proportional to?
Heck yes!
So I got Newton to stop writing that lousy fanfiction?
Not quite. He just changed the title to Larry Plotter and the Inverse Square Law of Gravitation. But, you know, close enough to save the universe.
So can I come home now? Please?
Sorry, Kelvin. There's at least one more anomaly we need to fix immediately.
Lame. Why don't we switch jobs for this one?
Oh, because you don't know how to use any of the equipment in the lab? Except the massage chair.
He has a name, Lise.
Except Fabio Armand Comichel.
Thank you.
Time machine incoming.
This isn't where I left my loofah. That's not my time machine! What the heck is it? And where'd the shower get to?
Oh dear. Yes, hello, gentlemen. I was hoping you could direct me toward the-
Are you seeing this, bros? Did that dude just walk out of a magic shower, bro?
He did, bro. What a weirdo.
Hey, Lise, quick question. Do we get to keep our jobs when this is all over?
You mean our jobs working for the total whack job scientist who went back in time just to steal a bunch of intellectual property?
Yep, those.
I'm thinking no.
Oh, man. I really don't want to have to go back to my last job.
What was it?
You know that weird billionaire Andreas Pries?
Didn't he make that dating app where you only get to see the other person's nose?
Yeah, I was his personal napkin. I wore a big white t-shirt, and whenever he ate something with a lot of sauce...
Hey! Why don't we start the mission? Looks like you're in Florence around 1503.
Huh? Oh, who am I here to help?
Leonardo da Vinci, which is a bit of a problem. He's famous for about a million different things. Incredible inventions, beautiful paintings, landmark anatomical research.
So we have no idea what Lupin kept him from doing.
Right. We can only hope Leonardo has some idea. Good luck, Kelvin.
Why is there a naked dude on this sign? Uh-oh, something weird's coming. Time to activate stealth mode. Well, that wasn't even remotely suspicious. I think it's a book of alchemy recipes. Man, this guy's handwriting is awful. I can't read any of these. Oh, wait, here we go. This one's for a brownification elixir. Boil one raven feather to create base darkening agent. Add sliced tentabell root as needed to achieve desired brown hue. Mix in ground femur to enhance bonding properties? What kind of incense is this? It smells like sweaty trout.
You've never smelt lupin's breath before?
Oh my god, that's exactly what this is.
Those are samples, if you'd like to take one.
Whoa! I never realized the moon was this old. Aw, look at the widow cuties! You don't need a hoe to dig graves, right? I'll just borrow this for a while. Hey, these drawings are pretty good. Maybe the gravedigger's making a comic about a guy with severe mood swings. This thread count is incredible. Somebody knows how to shop for linens. You know how sometimes in adventure games, the protagonist will pick something up, even though nobody in their right mind would go anywhere near that thing? This is one of those times.
Oh, God! Oh, it smells exactly like blue cheese!
The rest of these don't look ripe.
I thought I told you to stay out!
I just saw an old pigeon out in the courtyard. I think it was dying.
Out of my way! That's two good meals, at least!
Whew, this should keep her out for a little while, at least. Looks like it's empty.
Open this door right now!
Coming! I just slipped on some gravy. She's not gonna want to use the cracked ones, right? I'll just grab a few of those.
You got till the count of three to...
Hang on, it's really windy out here. I can't get to the door. Am I the kind of person that would steal meat out of somebody else's stew? Huh, guess I am. I should really work on that.
What's going on out there?
Just a minute. I think the hinges are covered in syrup.
What did you do?
Nothing. Nothing. Door just got stuck for a second. Okay, bye. Do plants with teeth eat other plants? I have to test this.
For science!
Remarkable. I'll just hold on to this. The owner's probably a little too chewed up to need it. Bingo! I think I can move these discs now. It looks like you can swap out the head and the hand somehow. No need. I already entered the right code. Commence Operation Trojan Corpse.
Are you okay, Kelvin? You look like you've seen a dead body.
Yeah, about that?
Oh, no.
You killed Leonardo, didn't you? Murderer! You doomed us all!
What? No! I'm in a creepy laboratory with a corpse.
A corpse? Did you kill the corpse?
How could I kill a corpse? A corpse is a corpse.
Of course, but the corpse wasn't always a corpse.
Oh my god, Lise, I didn't kill the corpse.
All right. Sorry. Anyway, good news. I've trapped Lupin in a temporal stasis field. If you can finish with Da Vinci before the field dissolves, I can bring you both back simultaneously.
Why don't you just bring Lupin back now?
If I bring either of you back first, the chronotunnel might collapse, trapping the other in the past.
Which would create an anomaly so massive that it would definitely destroy the universe.
Yeah, pretty much.
I'm on the job. Kelvin out. There's something real suspicious about how unsuspicious this book looks.
Called it.
What the? It's a painting of a bulldog in a flowery dress? Whoa, cool! Toy of the Year 1503! Oh, neat! I made something like this when I was 9 so I could pull my cousin Sarah's ponytail from across the room. Which, of course, led cousin Sarah to retaliate with her pneumatic spitball cannon. Basically, my childhood was a terrifying arms race. Well, it looks like a to-do list, but it's all backwards. There's only one item that isn't crossed off. Take catapult designs to castle for approval from the Duke. All this stuff looks fragile and half-finished. Oh, hey, neat! These are for some sort of giant weapon.
Welcome, sir. Looking for anybody in particular?
Just, browsing.
Oh, take your time. They ain't going anywhere. Mostly.
I'm in the market for a leg bone?
You Leonardo's new assistant, then?
I am, yes. I assist him with all bone-related matters.
So, you bring the goods?
Goods? What kind of goods?
If you're really Leonardo's assistant, you know exactly what kind of goods.
Oh, right. Those goods. Yeah, let me, go get them. See you around.
Toodles!
I have the goods, I think.
Oh, my God! I love it, I love it, I love it! You wanted a leg, right? Be right back. Here you go! Don't use it all in one place!
I've got some new blueprints from Leonardo da Vinci that need to be approved.
Likely story. Let's see him. Huh. Old man must be starting to lose it if he's hired the likes of you. Go on through. Any funny business, and I'll spear you good.
I'll just slip the formula somewhere in the middle here.
Hmm? Yes, what is it, commoner?
Are you the Duke?
Am I the Duke? Do you think the Duke answers his own door? Do you know anything about dukes?
So, you're like the Duke's weird friend.
I'm his doorman, you simpleton! Due to budget cuts, I also act as his valet, his notary, his stunt double, and his Thursday night wingman.
Notary? Does that mean you, like, sign stuff for him?
If by stuff you mean missives critical to the governance and preservation of the state?
So, boring stuff.
Yes, boring stuff. Now what do you want?
I have some blueprints from Leonardo that need to be signed.
You're not Leonardo's usual courier. Where's Olgiati?
Who?
Matthias Olgiati. Enormous mustache, always wears 12 belts for some reason.
Oh, Matthias. Right. He moved. He fell in love with a beltsmith up in Venice. They didn't want to do the long distance thing.
Sensible, but a shame. He was a fine courier. Very well. Where are these blueprints?
What
Is this a formula for hair dye?
Huh? No, that's catapult dye.
Why the devil would anyone bother to dye a catapult?
Well, after a while, they start to go gray.
I can't tell if you're joking, but I'd rather just sign this than investigate it further.
That's the spirit.
These appear to be in order. I trust that's everything.
Sure is. Thanks.
Behold, my revolutionary remote incense delivery system. Trademark. Patent pending. Remote incense delivery system, deploy!
Drink in the stink, bees. You know you hate it.
Stinger One, this is Mission Command. You are clear to engage the Hive. Good luck, soldier.
Bravest tiny helicopter I ever saw.
Wow, this is sticky, even for honey.
Oh, sweet! I've wanted one of these since I was 6.
Ugh, now the cheesy smell is super concentrated inside the jar.
I guess I will leave this delicious piece of actual cheese directly outside this hole. I sure hope it will not be eaten by a rodent or small dog. Mwahahaha! It's not cheese at all, silly rat!
Your nose has betrayed you!
Don't forget the air holes, kids. Well, it's got a little honey on it, but overall, it's a pretty nice feather. I'm not going anywhere near that thing again without incapacitating it somehow.
Your rat poison is a joke. This rat ate a whole bottle's worth and he's fine.
What? How can this be?
I demand a refund.
Huh. No cash refunds. Store credit or nothing.
Store credit it is.
Very well. Let me know when you've decided on an item. And let's keep word of this product defect between us, shall we?
My lips are zipped. You got anything that could tame an angry plant?
Is that monstrosity by the graveyard acting up again?
You know about it?
I created it. Accidentally, I admit. Spilled one of my most volatile concoctions on an innocent little weed.
Then you gotta have something that can calm it down.
I have pills that should soothe it, yes.
I'll take them.
Very well. How will you be paying this evening?
Let me get back to you.
can I use my store credit on those pills for the plant?
Huh. I suppose that's fair. Here you are. Best of luck convincing the plant to take them.
Excuse me? I'd like to...
Ah!
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 Why are you screaming?
You screamed first!
That's preposterous. I would never do such a thing. Now, what alchemical needs do you have? I'm afraid I'm very busy.
Okay, I got the Duke to sign off on the formula. Can you make the dye now?
Huh? What? Oh, let me see again. I don't have any of these ingredients in the shop right now.
What if I found them for you?
Then I suppose I could squeeze you in. But good luck finding a raven's feather, a tantalus root, and a human femur on short notice.
See you later.
Huh? Yes, fine, whatever.
Sleeping pills and meat. Two great tastes that go great together. Chew on this, you grumpy shrub. Dang, that thing's gonna be out for days. One raven feather.
Is this honey?
Yeah. See, first I smeared honey all over a gravestone, and then...
Good Lord, forget I asked.
This is a tentabell root, right?
Indeed it is. And a sizable one at that.
What can I say? I know how to pick 'em. That's everything, right? Can we finally make this dye, or what?
Very well. Just a moment. Here you are. Please give my regards to the Duke. I have charged his account as usual.
Will do. Thanks, bud. Honestly, this is going to be the highlight of my entire life. That ruled. Ooh, maybe if I drop the dye on Mona from here, she won't even notice. Here goes nothing. Worth a shot.
Kelvin! Lupin's temporal stasis... Kelvin, why do I hear crying in the background?
Oh, that's Mona. I might have dyed her hair without her permission to make her look more like her sister.
You what? Kelvin, what happened to helping Leonardo da Vinci?
I am helping him. Leonardo was going to paint Mona's sister, but Lupin prevented that.
So you and Leonardo decided the best course of action was to gussy up Mona?
Exactly!
Ugh, men. I feel gross even asking, but did it work?
Well, her hair's the right color, but now there's the whole uncontrollable weeping thing.
Could I make a suggestion, Kelvin?
Of course!
Apologize, you lugnut! And hurry! Lupin's temporal stasis field is starting to decay.
Okay, listen. If I break you guys out, will you help me cheer up a lady who won't stop crying?
Proposal. Didn't go so well, huh, bud?
I believe what Groblu meant to say was, oh my god, yes, please! We'll do literally anything! I had intended to sneak a file into our cell as we were jailed, but I was bumped by a certain lunkhead, and I dropped it into the grate at your feet. I'm sure it's still down there, somewhere.
Let's see what's hiding down here. Looks like a raven feather, a human leg bone, some sort of root, ooh, and a file. Come on, let's blow this joint!
Quick question, if I may. How do we intend to elude the ill-tempered fellow with the spear?
Follow me! There's a tunnel by the Rose Garden that I used to steal the Duke's dishware!
Groblu, you devious little plate smuggler. I could kiss you.
How about you don't? We call it even.
I thought I told you to stay out!
All right, let's Easter these up. You guys are good. Mona's already stopped crying.
But of course, we are graduates of the finest fooling academy in the city-state.
Well, I am anyway. This clown never finished one of his requirements.
Oh, please. How much would I really have gotten out of intro to poop jokes?
Depends on what you put in.
Could we maybe change things up a little? Mona's still pretty down in the dumps.
I suppose we could, switch to the clubs.
Time to give him the old switcheroo. Mind if we, change things up again?
You're the boss, boss! Hey, don't these feel a little...
Christmas cactus! My God! That's it! That's the smile I've so longed to capture!
Well then don't just stand there, man! Paint! Paint!
It looks great. What are you going to call it?
Originally, I had intended to call it simply the Lisa, but given the particulars of the creation...
You!
Wait! Are you screaming at me or Leonardo?
I believe he is addressing you.
Why do you say that?
I've never encountered this man before, and it sounds as though the two of you are well acquainted. Not to mention that he appeared out of thin air, highly suggestive of time travel.
You really are a genius. Have you ever thought about doing a web series?
A series of webs? I'm not familiar with...
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! How did the brain-dead likes of you manage to thwart my efforts at every turn?
Well, just now I painted some eggs, and then I tricked some clowns into juggling them, which caused...
Enough! If you had been half this effective while we were building the machine, none of this would have had to happen!
I mean, honestly, I think the bigger problem is your weird obsession with plumbing.
Excuse me?
It's kind of hard to take these inventions seriously when they all look like a bathroom. Like, even right now. Not super intimidating.
Not intimidating. Not intimidating! I'll show you intimidating! Die!
Kelvin, come in. You're disintegrated, are you?
Please, it's Lupin. He...
I know. He broke out of the temporal stasis field.
He's kidnapped Leonardo, Newton, and Beethoven. We're all trapped in his vault. Also, apparently Lupin has a vault.
I'll find him and I'll convince him to surrender. I think I can get through to him.
Kelvin... The man built a battle mech out of a bathtub. There's no getting through to him.
Listen carefully. We have a plan, but we need a few things from you. A wheel, a magnet, and... Mr. Beethoven, what did you need from Kelvin again?
What? Speak up!
What do you need from Kelvin?
A horn.
A what?
A horn! What are you, deaf?
A horn, for some reason. I'll text you the list.
Also, before Lupin captured me, I configured the time machine to loop through its last three destinations. When you've got everything we need, just hit the manual override to come home.
Wait, what was the manual override again?
Turn the cold water on full blast.
What? I think I'd rather destroy the universe.
Kelvin, get moving! I'll buzz you whenever Lupin's closing in on your location.
Aw, man. If these had been here before, I could have looked even fancier. I'm a time-traveling jewel thief!
We meet again, Mr. Magnet.
Hey, I remember these from geometry class. They're for making circles, right? Score one for simple machines.
Time is up, Aaron boy.
I'm not sure how those go together. That impresario dude is gonna be mad. Please, I found everything.
Great work, Kelvin. Toss the stuff in first. I don't want that magnet interfering with your bio signal.
What the?
Behold, idiot! The Symphonic Spider! It will feature prominently in my next fanfiction, in which Larry Platter is forced to...
Can it wait, Isaac? There's an awful lot at stake.
No one ever appreciates my craft.
Formation, people! Lupin is incoming!
Oh, how convenient! Now I can destroy all of you at once!
Give it up, boss! You're outmanned and outgunned.
Outgunned? By what? You built a Frankenstein's piano.
Says the cook in the working bathtub.
Cook, I'm the most stable person in the room.
Clearly.
That's it. So long, so-called geniuses.
Ludwig, now!
What?
Now!
Oh, right.
At least, I still have mini golf.
We did it! I can't believe it!
A fine job, time traveler. Your dopey appearance belies an unexpected competence.
We are indebted to you, Kelvin. You have inspired each one of us to continue our work with a renewed vigor.
Whatever. I still think he's a moron.
Kelvin, you just saved us. You just saved the universe.
Well, you did all the important science stuff, Leeds. All I did was use random objects on other random objects until everything worked out.
But don't you see, my boy? That is science.
No, it's not. It's not even close.
Would you shut up? I'm trying to encourage him.
Kelvin, this is a violation of typical workplace etiquette, and to be clear, is by no means an obligation of mine to reward your heroism, but regardless. Great job, Kelvin.